gentlemen, we've got the big boys back in the ring. Six rounds of boxing in the heavyweight division. Your referee in charge is Frank Gentile. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the blue trunks. He weighed in at 289.25 pounds with a record of 8 wins, 10 losses, 1 draw. All 8 wins coming by way of knockout from Nassau, Bahamas. Please welcome Jerry Big Daddy Butler. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the red trunks. He weighed in at 240.75 pounds. He is undefeated with a record of 6 wins, no losses, 4 wins coming by way of knockout. He is the 2005 amateur world champion, originally from Cuba, now fighting out of Hollywood, Florida. He is Luis El Mercedes Ortiz.
You know, and you would assume that Ortiz is going to come out and use his height and reach advantage, which is substantial. You know, an interesting statement that Jason Gavin made to us yesterday about using that advantage and not working a body. I wonder if Ortiz is going to follow something similar. You know, he's 6'4". He's a southpaw. But listen, we're going to know here in a few minutes, but to me, he kind of looks uncoordinated.
You know, and he does not look that warmed up. Considering how warm it is here, it doesn't seem like there's a drop of sweat on him. Whereas Butler looks a little more warm up.
It looks like he's taking this fight a little lightly. Oh, he is working
right
the body.
Middle.
That's a smart move. You know, he looks a little like Riddick Bowe, doesn't he?
I was going to say Teofilo Stevenson.
Missed with the left over the top.
A blonde Teofilo Stevenson.
That's a Dennis Rodman hairdo he's got right there.
Yeah, he is a big man.
Nice uppercut to the body. He landed that. He's got some speed. You know, I was wrong. He seems, he's definitely got some upper body agility, that's for sure. His trunks seem a little high.
Yeah, I was just going to say, they are almost to his nipples.
Yeah, they're a little high. Again, he's working the body. And this was something, to be honest with you, I thought that Jason Gavin was mistaken with his assumption that just because you're bigger, you shouldn't work the body.
Yeah, the idea of, that you would be giving up any height advantage by reaching in for the body. You know, at least so far what we've seen here with Ortiz, that's not the case. However, one way to avoid that is to pull your trunks up to your breasts.
You know, Ortiz, he seems to be taking this lightly. And he, for a big guy, he's compact. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Very tightly built.
I can't tell if it's all legs or the fact that his trunks are up so high.
I think they are up so ridiculously high, and it almost is making his legs look oddly. It's like they go into his hips on a strange angle, but I don't think it's that's the case. I think it's just that the trunks have sort of bloused out, and they're pulled up so high that it's giving him a strange look.
He doesn't seem to be hurting Butler. Seems like he's in good shape, Ortiz.
Well, we can't see his belly.
This is true. And you know, there is kind of a bulge. It could just be the protection. But, again, he's acting as if this is not a tough fight for him. And Butler does have power. I mean, with his 8 wins, they're all knockouts. I'll tell you, Butler... It's a different pair of trunks. His are snugly.
Yeah, fit. His are. He might lose his, and the other one, you can't pull him up any higher.
You know, what can Butler do? I mean, to me, the only thing that he could really do is try and get in close and get Ortiz against the rope somehow. But instead, it's the other way around.
Yeah, Ortiz has driven Butler to the ropes a couple times here with those straight punches, but he seems to be loading up tremendously.
He's got the 10-second warning. He's not allowed to measure. That's against the rule. Butler seems to be more of a sportsman than Ortiz is. He doesn't like, ooh, that's after the bell. And I'll tell you, he's landed a couple of solid shots that are not affecting Butler one bit, at least at this stage of the game.
Yeah.
You know, I'm
and
seeing.
And it does look like the referee is going to make it with his drums there now, which is, I think, a good idea because it's ridiculous. I've seen how high they are.
I think Butler almost seems like, you know, he's in not that bad a shape. Wind-wise, body-wise, he obviously is.
Right.
But you know, I think Ortiz is either he fooled around that round, or he's taken this opponent very lightly. He is pulling the old George Foreman. He's not sitting on his stool, which is ready for him to sit on.
Okay, yeah, now they fixed his drums.
There's still a lot of leg on that guy, but Butler comes out. He's bouncing around a little, all of them.
And now he seems to be letting his hands go a little more.
He's acting like he's all that. Yeah, you got to be confident in the ring, right, Alex?
Yeah, and I do think that we've seen this already in the other fighters, is that there tends to be an arrogance in the Cuban fighters, and you know, when they back that up, it's nice to see that, but when they don't, it's a little annoying. So far, what we're seeing here is, you know, I think a more skilled guy fighting a durable guy.
Good point, and I think that's exactly what we see. But I also see that some of these shots that are landing flush on Butler do not seem to be affecting him at all. There's no swelling. It's not stopping him from coming forward. I just think that it's a lack of skill. I think what we have here is just a tough guy.
Yeah, and he does seem to be in better shape than he appears to be, and that could be, you know, like we talked about earlier with Medina, that maybe this guy who spends a lot of time sparring, and you know, he doesn't do his road work and his conditioning, but in terms of combat readiness, he is that.
He's missing with his shots. He's trying to counterpunch, and Ortiz landed a pretty solid shot. I mean, flush that Butler seemed to walk through. But he does have more rolls than a bakery.
He does. I don't know if he was reacting to what I just said.
I didn't think he liked your comment. And, you know, he kind of gave you a rolling of the eyes.
He did look like him.
I think he likes himself pretty much, but he's definitely winning this fight. He shows some decent hand speed. I got to give him that. And I like the fact that he's working the body. Because that's what he's got to do, and I think regardless of the height advantage, that he still needs to work that body, because that has to be a weakness with Butler. And, you know, he obviously can take some shots, because he's taken some solid flush shots that Ortiz has landed, like,
yeah,
right now.
Definitely, and that's one of the things that just physiologically, there are more nerve endings in fat than there are in muscle. So in a guy like this, where you have this, you know, very copious midriff, go ahead and work it, because he might react to it quicker than the headshots.
I think we overestimated the condition of Jerry Butler, because his hands all of a sudden have stopped throwing.
Yeah, he's gotten real tired.
You know, he was trying to avoid the onslaught that Ortiz was giving him, landing plenty of those punches, and I think they are starting to catch up with Jerry Butler. Again, we have our Rinka girls, I think part of those dancers that came out as part of that team, with the pink basketballs instead of ring cards.
Yeah.
They seem to be having some fun out there.
They are officially ring girls, not ring women. Wow, and it looks like we got some, it's pretty interesting seeing an outdoor fight like this. There's all kinds of stuff going on. We got some bird activity in here. Look at that. There's a hawk being pursued by some small birds. Notice that?
And that small bird just might be a kamikaze.
Yeah,
he just rammed
into him. Got a fight going on out there.
Again, Ortiz is not using the stool, preferring to stay standing.
Here we go, round number three.
Round three. And, you know, I think that if Ortiz does follow up with that jab, I mean, you know, use his jab to follow up with his left. I think it would be more beneficial to him, and just especially for this size difference. You know, it seems to me anyway. I'm no Sherman Henson.
Yeah, I mean, these straight punches seem to be doing some damage for Ortiz, but you know, not as much damage as we thought we were going to see quickly here. And Butler just landed a nice left hook, and I saw a little bit of slick movement right there from Jerry Butler.
Butler did some head movement in the at the end of the prior round, in the second round, which I think he started doing because he's starting to get arm weary. But, you know, to tell you the truth, Ortiz could be a little more aggressive here. Because,
I think, yeah, you're absolutely,
you know, I mean, if he lets his hands go, he might take him out of here. It looks like Butler's running out of whatever energy he had. And, you know, what Ortiz does not want to do is to make Butler look better than what he should.
Right. And I think also here what's happening is, you know, maybe this isn't Ortiz's style to, you know, just flatten a guy. His nickname is El Mercedes. It's not the Ferrari.
Nice. He's got him in trouble now. He did land a solid punch. He's got to follow up with that. He stunned him a little bit, and Butler is coming at him. And you know what? He is unleashing. He is unleashing.
Yep, and the corner. And, you know, a very similar stoppage to our first fight stoppage. Same exact thing just happened. Where in the red corner, you know, Ortiz started landing a lot of hard unanswered shots, and the corner of Butler came up under the ring apron and asked for the fight to be stopped.
Was it the same team?
I don't think so. No.
No, that team was in the Bahama fight. He had the other Bahama kid that there was no
Moxie.
That kid was not Moxie was knocked out.
I think Moxie, correct.
This particular fight, I thought that it was inevitable. I think that Butler was running out of gas, and what impressed me about Ortiz is that when he did get him in trouble, he let his hands go to show us that he not only does he have power, but he's got some accuracy, and he did what he had to do.
Definitely, and he did. He turned up the pressure nicely.
We're gonna go up to ring announcer Mark Litchfield. With the official announcement, and then we'll talk about a replay, which we're gonna see.
At 1:40 of the third round, your winner by technical knockout and still undefeated, Luis.
So the official time was 1:40 of the third round, as we are going to get to see a replay here. And this is I think that right hand was the one that put him in some trouble, and he just unleashed a barrage of punches that he wasn't responding to. Again, I agree with you that you know that punch. And you know what? That left hand might have been the one that did the most damage, Alex.
Yeah, it does seem that there were several unanswered shots, but it was hard to see which one. That their guy was just under attack, and that Ortiz was going to open up, and was opening up. But it looks like Butler was in the process of responding.
Well, Butler was seriously in trouble in that fight towards that stoppage. But again, like you, I think that they kind of stopped it pretty quickly. I also thought that Ortiz started to show me what I expected him to do. By letting his hands go and dominate the fight when he saw his opponent in trouble, which gives me a sense that I think that he is a seasoned guy. You know, he didn't rush. Maybe he was fooling around. Maybe he did want to drag that the big guy that seemed like he was out of shape into the deep water.
Right, and as I was starting to say, you know, if you put any important nicknames, he's a Mercedes, so he's a classy cruiser. He's not a muscle car. He's not a speedster.
Well, I think and Jerry Butler must have been a pickup truck.
Yeah.